Hi guys, and welcome to part two of the news writing video. So my last video, we talked about how to write an inverted pyramid and what is news. And then this video, we'll talk a bit about interviews and story ideas. But first off, I wanted to spend some time on active versus passive voice. So news stories are written in active voice. So active voice is when the subject acts upon its verb, whereas passive voice is when the subject is a recipient of a verb's action. So an example of active voice is, Harry ate 6 shrimp at dinner. An example of passive voice is, at dinner, 6 shrimp were eaten by Harry. So something that I do after I write a story is I just go through it and just check for active versus passive voice and try to catch the passive voice. Okay, so the interview. So before picking up the phone or walking into an interview, prepare questions. Do research. Research the topic and the person you're going to be interviewing. Set aside some time before your interview to prepare for the interview. Come in with a list of questions, but also be prepared to ask questions based off of what your source is telling you. So you're going to be listening carefully and be using your critical thinking skills to be asking yourself, okay, what information do I now need to be asking about? What do I need to be asking about now that I know this new information based off of what your source is telling you? So if you don't understand a response or your source didn't answer your question, just ask it again or try another way of approaching it. There is no shame in asking someone to explain something to you like you were a first grader. I do that all the time when I talk to doctors and they throw around these medical terms and jargon that I don't understand. Because if you don't understand it, there's a good chance your editor won't be able to understand it. And your reader definitely won't be able to understand it either. So when you interview for stories, you want to get different points of view. Rarely does a story have just one source in it. You're going to want to have typically about 3 different sources throughout your story. So it's good to get multiple points of view. When you're writing an issue story, you need to get both sides of the issues. Talk to Democrats and Republicans. Talk to people who are affected by the issues, because journalists give a voice to people. When possible, it's best to put a face on a story. It's best to talk to someone to help humanize a story because people want to read about people. When I was writing the story that I mentioned in my other video about the cost of insulin going up for diabetics, I talked to a few people who use insulin and I discussed with them how this rising cost is impacting them. Now, also don't be afraid to ask for big interviews. Ask to interview the coach or the principal. Don't just assume it's going to be an automatic no, because you could be surprised. Okay, so in quotes and fact-checking, so with quotes are really good. They're important to have throughout your story, but you also don't want to overload your story with too many quotes. Don't just quote someone to use a quote. If you can write it better than your source said it, write it out. After all, you are the writer here, and this is your story. Now, fact-checking is also really important. After I finish a story, I like to spend some time fact-checking any numbers, names, or any facts. Watch out for misspellings. Always ask people to spell out their names. If it's the most common and simple name, you want to be sure to ask and double-check, because people can surprise you sometimes with their names. All right, now I want to wrap up talking a little bit about story ideas. So always be curious. As a journalist, always be asking questions and never be satisfied. Also, talk to your friends and classmates about what they want to read. All right, so this is what I had for you guys. Another tip I have real quick before I leave you is, after I'm all done with my story, I've done my fact-checking, I've checked for passive and active voice, I like to step away from the article for a little bit, take a little break, and then come back to it with what I call like a fresh set of eyes. And then just read through it again to make sure that I like the story and that it makes sense to me and it will make sense to my readers. All right, guys. Well, that's all I got for you. So thank you all for your time.